research, I was going to look into it, and find all the best mentors I could. Which ended up being me watching a lot of episodes of The Voice. I mean, Christina Aguilera is a great mentor, so it's not the worst. But something I noticed while I was watching, and something I've seen in other TV shows as well, is the frequent misuse of the word risk. Have you ever noticed that? They always say things like, "That was a risky song choice." But they always say it with a face, like, "Good luck, you're gonna need it." And I don't get that. I never got that. Because, I mean, the definition of the word risky is the possibility of loss or harm. Okay, so, using that definition, everything is risky. I mean, think about it. You wake up every day, you go through your life knowing full well that bad things could happen. There's always a risk involved. That's a great thing because if there were no risks, then life wouldn't be what we know it to be today. I mean, so don't. But then we get people like the judges on The Voice who say things like risk, and they say it's a terrible thing. And I get so angry because well-educated, smart risks have the possibility to produce the biggest rewards. And I have to emphasize the smart and well-educated part, because risks that are just, they don't measure the impact that they can have, they're just risks for risk's sake, aren't really risky at all, they're just foolish. The perfect risk is a combination between knowledge and passion. So, why am I talking about this, and why is it so important to me? I don't know about you, but I grew up in an environment where no one wanted to be that kid. And by that kid, I mean a kid who actually did anything. But the idea was, it's cool not to care. Because if you care, you open yourself up to the risk of failing, saying something dumb, humiliating yourself. And that's scary stuff. So where I was from, the solution to all that was just don't. Don't try too hard, don't stand out, just be cool. And that was a really conflicting message for me because on one hand, there's this if you're failing, you don't want to, stand out too much, but on the other hand, you want to feel good, you want to do something, have some pride in your work. So there are times where I was kind of stuck in this awkward middle ground where I would have loved to stand out and do something, but on the other hand, I felt as if I wasn't supposed to. It wasn't what I was supposed to do. So I'd end up in situations where this would come up a lot. Like if my teacher would ask the class a question and I knew the answer and I really wanted to say something about it, I had to just talk with him. I was like, "Oh, no one's hands up, all right." And I have to do that a lot. I don't explain it just me. But where I was from, the mentality was, what you're doing right now really won't make a difference in the long run. So just go with it. Go along for the ride. Don't make too many waves. And it took me years to realize that wasn't true. That the world is constantly changing, and we're the people changing it. And I started to believe this after hearing a Steve Jobs quote. But I don't know it. It goes something like, everything in this thing called life was created by someone no smarter than you. And you can change it, you can influence it, and you can build things that other people can use. That was so crazy to me, because it was a concept that went totally against everything I knew. But it made so much sense. So I had this newfound confidence that I could do something. And not just that, I could do something and it would mean something. But what would I do? So, like I said, risks are the combination between passion and knowledge. Now that I have this newfound knowledge, this is where my passion came from. So just as a bit of backstory, growing up I was overweight. And it's funny, I became overweight because I wanted to get on the big kid rides at Wonderland, and my mom said, you need to go good and strong, so I ate a lot. So it didn't work out for me, but I tried. But it didn't bother me that much when I was overweight. I think I was like 12 at the time, and I had my stomach watching, so I was confused. But then the teens had started. They're right. Maybe there's a reason why these people aren't talking to me. So I started, I joined a softball league, and I lost a lot of weight like that, naturally. But it wasn't good enough, and it wasn't fast enough, so I started visiting ProAnna, ProMia websites, which are pro-anorexia, pro-bulimia blogs. And they have all these commandments. that whole week, so I'd be happy. I'd go off and live this glamorous life. But it wasn't like that at all. I found another thing, like another thing. And it was a cycle. So instead of being happier than ever, which is what I thought I'd be, I was more miserable than I'd ever been in my whole life. And I didn't want anyone else to feel this way. So this was an issue I was really passionate about, something I was determined to change. So that coupled with the knowledge I had prior, and it's what led to One Silver Lining, which is a nonprofit organization that I founded. We're aimed at teen girls to promote positive body image while raising awareness about eating disorders. Currently, we reach up to 11,000 youth weekly, and we have chapters springing up in schools all over Europe region. We've had photo campaigns, and most recently, a benefit concert that raised over $600 for the National Eating Disorder Information Center. And just personally, I've had the chance to speak on behalf of One Silver Lining at events like TEDx with Mel and write for Flirt magazine. But none of this would have been a thing. One Silver Lining wouldn't have existed if it wasn't for me deciding to take that initial risk. And it wasn't the risk of starting an organization, it was the risk of actually doing something. And you guys are probably way further than I was initially, because you're here. So you already have some idea of how you have to make a difference. Now it's all about what you do with it. I'm not saying that finding your passion is going to be easy, because it's not. But when you find it, you know. Because the work doesn't feel like work anymore, and when you fail, which trust me, you will, because you have to, it won't faze you. You'll just want to keep going because there'll be something bigger motivating you. Once you realize that everything you want is attainable, there's really no limit to what you can do, and I know that sounds super cheesy, I know. But so many people want success, and they want change, and they want to make a difference. So go out there and get it, and earn it, and do it because you can. I mean, you might be listening to this and thinking, that sounds like a lot of work. Because it is. It's a lot of work. But the only other option is to, stand back and say, well, I'm just going to wish and I'm going to hope that it happens. Maybe, maybe if I think about it hard enough, maybe, something will happen for me. But if you refuse an active role in your own life,